Hey everyone, my name is Marten Hørger. My brand new song, Another Dimension Part 2, is out now. And today, I'm showing you how I made it. So when it comes to my music, there's basically two things that I'm super obsessed with. One is big, bad, wild, crazy, stupid, loud dance music. The crazy stuff. And then there is the classic side of dance music, like classic house, sample-based, beautiful female vocals, house pianos. So those two things together, that's me. I started this song the same way that I start every song, with the idea, because I think that what makes a song last and what makes a song popular is never the mixdown, the master, or the sound. It's always the idea, the underlying, fundamental vision of it. And that brings me to the song idea of Another Dimension Part 2. I had already made a song called Another Dimension, which was a very weird song, but it was a very big song for me. And it's also how Tiesto heard about me for the first time. So I had the idea to make a part two of it and put everything that I stand for into one song. After that song came out, I found this vocal. I'm gonna take you to another dimension. I'm gonna take you to another dimension. I took that vocal, looped it. I'm gonna take you to another dimension. To another dimension. To another dimension. Then I wrote the piano. And then I put a respace underneath it. And that made me so happy. So I knew that this is gonna be it. This is gonna be the song idea that I'm gonna base everything else around. A lot of people ask me how I make bass lines, and I'm very easily confused, so I love simple stuff. I usually, when I go about making a bass, I usually start with an 808, with a sample or an 808 generator or anything. And in this case, I used Mark Yardley's, remember it, Mark Yardley's 808 bass rack. He's a very good friend of mine, and I use this a lot. And in this case, I used that one. And all that is an 808 sound that's been processed and layered and processed and layered over and over again. For extra classic dance music vibes, I usually use this kind of plugin. It's called the Rave Generator. And it has those kind of sounds in it. And I put it in the background to give those classic vibes together with modern production. And the rest of the song is very, very simple, because again, I love simple stuff. Because the secret to having a fat, nice, round mixdown in the loud master is, drum roll, it's simplicity. If you keep things super simple, it's very easy to make it fat. A lot of people that come into my studio ask me about the difference between all the analog stuff and the digital stuff. And the truth is, it doesn't matter. There's certain things that you can only do with analog things and certain things that you can only do in the computer. But as I said before, the one thing that counts above everything else is the idea of the song. And just because you have analog equipment doesn't mean that you can turn anything into a big record. And the reason why I have most of these things is because they're fun. That's the only reason. And I'm pretty sure that I could do everything just on a laptop, but it just wouldn't be as much fun. And all of this put together with some magic sprinkled on top turns into the final song, and it's out now. Thank you all so much for watching this. Thank you all so much for listening.